I'm going to be showing you 5 different ways to change volume in DaVinci Resolve. Those 5 ways are going to cover both clips and channels with a couple of methods for each. We're going to start with clips, so the individual pieces of audio you have in your timeline. We'll cover 3 ways to change the volume of a clip, then we'll move to channels where we'll cover 2 ways to adjust your channel volume. I'd like to give a huge shout out and a thank you to the buyers of coffee from last week and remind you guys that if this video ends up being very helpful for you or making you a bunch of money, it would be much appreciated if you'd consider buying me a coffee with the link in the description. For this tutorial, we'll be using this clip of some music I pulled from Epidemic Sound. Oregano. There will be a link in the description if you like it and want to find it. Now that it's out here, we can see that audio track 1 is populated with our song. If we zoom in a little bit, we can clearly see the waveform of this audio. The first way we're going to cover is the least precise way we have to get this done. If we hover our mouse over this line right here, you'll see the cursor change. We can click and drag this line up or down to make some very coarse adjustments to our clip's volume. We go from 0 decibels in some very aggressive jumps up or down depending on which way we drag the line. Our next method of changing the volume of a clip is going to utilize our inspector panel. This method allows us some extreme precision for our volume adjustment. In order to do this, we'll select our clip so it's outlined in red, then we'll head up to our inspector panel where we see this volume slider with this little text input next to it. We can drag this slider to the right to make it louder or to the left to bring that volume down. And we can see that visually represented in the clip's waveform. In order to get really precise with this, we'll click in the text box we looked at earlier and put in any decibel value we want down to the second decimal place. The third method we're going to look at is volume ramping. This can be a good way to utilize both of the first methods to get a really clean transition from one volume to another. So, we'll see this little keyframe diamond up here in the inspector panel. If we click on that, we'll set a volume level for right now. Then, if we move forward in our timeline, we can set a new volume level however far in the future we want. So, we'll ramp our volume up, and you can see those keyframes represented in our waveform again, as well as the gradual increase in volume. If we click on this little spline icon here, we can even go a little deeper and make this transition smooth by selecting a keyframe and selecting one of our transition buttons here. That'll wrap up our look at clip-based volume adjustment and lead us into our channel-based volume adjustment. This can be really useful if you have a track that contains all of your dialogue or all of your music or something like that, and you need to adjust it all the same amount across your composition. Method 1 for adjusting our volume by channel looks almost exactly like method 2 from the section on changing volume by clip. For this though, instead of selecting our clip, we'll select our audio track over here on the left. Once we do that, we'll see our volume options pop up in our inspector panel, just like before, but this time, that slider will change the entire track. Method 2 for adjusting an entire track is to use your mixer panel. You probably won't have this open right from the jump, but it's super easy to get to. Just come up here and click Mixer. That'll open up your mixer panel down here next to your timeline. Here, we can see all of our different audio tracks as well as our master track, which controls all of the tracks as one group. If we want to adjust any of our audio tracks, we can just slide these sliders up or down and adjust the volume super easily with a strong visual representation of what we're doing. If this video helped you out, it would be awesome if you'd subscribe, and if you really liked it, I'd appreciate it if you'd consider using the link in the description to buy me a coffee. I'll see you in the next one, and I hope you have a great day.